PokerStars was the most dominant poker site in the US for several years. When many other sites had ceased to operate in the region, PokerStars was strong. Despite eventually being forced to pull out of the US itself, it is still considered to be the largest online poker room in the world. It claims to have more than 50 million registered users and consistently has thousands of players online at one given time. What is up guys, Maxi from Poker Bounty bringing you today the story and the history of PokerStars. PokerStars was founded by an Israeli senior programmer for IBM Canada named Isai Sheinberg. He began to write the software that would form the basis of PokerStars in late 1990s and formed Rational Enterprises, originally based in Costa Rica, to operate his new poker site. On September 11, 2001, the site was launched in beta version for play money only. A few years later, in December, the real money version was opened. After a few years operating in Costa Rica, PokerStars announced a move to the Isle of Man, a British Crown dependency, in 2005. Sheinberg's decision to shift to this location was influenced by the 0% corporate tax rate and the island's policy to remove all bans on companies that were accepting poker bets from US players. The site was granted an e-gaming license by the Isle of Man Department of Home Affairs under its Gambling Regulation Act of 2001. After the move, Rational Enterprise was renamed to Rational Group. Employing more than 1,500 people in 20 different locations all over the world, Rational Group is among the biggest iGaming companies in the world. From the launch of real money games, PokerStars accepted players from all countries in the world, including players from the USA. Online poker experienced a dramatic rise in popularity in the mid-2000s, and this can largely be pinpointed to one single event, Chris Moneymaker's victory in the World Series of Poker event in 2003. Moneymaker was a full-time accountant and part-time poker player who enjoyed dabbling with the game in his spare time. Moneymaker entered a $39 satellite tournament at PokerStars and won himself a seat into a larger satellite. He went on to win that one too, earning entry into the WSOP main event. What happened after that was nothing short of a miracle. Chris Moneymaker won the WSOP main event, and with his win, he gave online poker and especially PokerStars a huge boost. Amateur poker players were suddenly flocking to online poker sites around the world, trying to emulate the rags-to-riches story of their new poker hero, Chris Moneymaker. PokerStars in particular benefited enormously from what came to be known as the Moneymaker effect. After Moneymaker's victory in 2003, PokerStars was on a roll in terms of WSOP qualifiers. A year later, the site qualified 315 players for the 100K championship event, which is 15% of the total tournament players. At the time, the vice president for marketing for PokerStars, Dan Goldman, said, "Our players continue to prove that their online tournament poker experience has tremendous value in a live tournament environment. The ease and convenience of playing poker online provides millions of people with tournament poker experience before they ever set foot in a casino or card room." In 2006, the Sheinberg family enlisted NM Rothschild, a large merchant bank in London, to explore options for floating or selling the company. At that time, PokerStars was valued at around $2 billion. Potential buyers include the Rang Group and William Hill, and there was also speculation that a merger could take place. It was widely believed that PokerStars would choose to float on the London Stock Exchange, following in the footsteps of some of its rivals, such as PartyPoker.com. Later in 2006, the UIGEA was introduced in the United States, making it illegal for financial institutions to process transactions from US residents that were related to online gambling. As a result, many gambling sites made the decision to pull out of the lucrative American market. Those that were publicly traded had no choice as they were answerable to their shareholders. As a privately owned company though, PokerStars could make its own decisions. PokerStars declared that it would not be seeking its previously planned IPO in the near future. The flotation that had been planned for the spring of 2007 was delayed indefinitely. The company made a strategic decision to continue serving North American players, filling the niche left in the US market by so many poker sites leaving. This is the biggest boost towards making PokerStars the top poker site in the world. The passing of the UIGEA forced companies like Party Poker to stop accepting American players. PokerStars decided to continue to accept American traffic despite the UIGEA bill and had a giant boost in traffic. They would continue to serve American players until April 15, 2011. It would face consequences for remaining active in the US in later years though. On December 27, 2009, PokerStars set the world record for the biggest online poker tournament. The tournament entry fees was $1 and the number of entrants reached 149,196 players. They broke that record on December 4, 2011 when 200,000 players played a $1 buy-in tournament with first prize of $50,000. PokerStars was so busy during the early stages of the tournament that all tournaments had to be stopped for 20 minutes because the heavy traffic crashed their servers. This record had been broken again at June 16, 2013 with 225,000 participants. The buy-in again was $1 and went completely into the prize pool with no rake. On April 15, 2011, known as Black Friday, PokerStars.com was seized by the Department of Justice with charges of violating the UIGA, money laundering, and bank fraud. PokerStars immediately stopped accepting American players and began a dialogue with the DOJ. All American player funds were frozen until a settlement with the DOJ could be reached. In May, only a few weeks after Black Friday, PokerStars had reached an agreement with the Department of Justice about facilitating cash outs. The Department of Justice returned the PokerStars.com domain in order to facilitate the American players' cash outs, and only a few weeks later, all the players were paid back in full. While PokerStars were paying all their players in timely manner, Full Tilt Poker struggled to do the same. The problem was caused by the fact that Full Tilt Poker did not have any money left due to bad money management. PokerStars saw this as an opportunity to strike a deal with the DOJ and obtain their main competitor at the same time, and started to negotiate the takeover of FullTiltPoker.com. In July of 2012, PokerStars finalized a deal with the DOJ. They would obtain Full Tilt Poker, pay a $731 million settlement, reimburse non-American players within 90 days, and facilitate American player cashouts with supervision by the DOJ. With the purchase of Full Tilt Poker and the settlement package of the DOJ, PokerStars was now allowed to apply for licenses in the US when such licenses would be available. On November 6, 2012, Full Tilt Poker was reopened under PokerStars management. Learning from their previous mistakes, PokerStars now obtained licenses for regulated markets. PokerStars obtained all major licenses in Europe, including the three ring nations, Italy, Spain, and France. Furthermore, PokerStars obtained a Maltese LGA license to provide tax-free games to the non-regulated countries within Europe. In June of 2014, the poker industry was shocked as the Rational Group, the company who owned both PokerStars and Full Tilt Poker, announced that they had to sell PokerStars, Full Tilt, and other brands under the Rational Group to Canadian gaming giants Amaya Gaming. Amaya Gaming paid a massive $4.9 billion for PokerStars and other brands under the Rational Group, and they told the world that they weren't planning on changing anything in the way the site was being administrated, keeping all employees and departments around the world. The only significant change was that Isai Scheinberg would no longer be in charge of the world's biggest poker site and most well-known poker brand. Not long after Amaya Gaming had taken over control of the brands, the first changes started happening for the players. The rake was increased, the rewards got lower, and new games were introduced along with casino games. The new PokerStars has not been very well accepted amongst the regulars on the site, but PokerStars is currently doing better than ever under Amaya's leadership. PokerStars has the biggest variety of different poker games found online, with 18 different types of poker. They have Texas Hold'em, Omaha, Omaha High-Low, 5-Card Omaha, 5-Card Omaha High-Low, Casherville, Casherville High-Low, 7-Card Stud, 7-Card Stud High-Low, Raz, Triple Stud, Horse and 8 Game, 5-Card Stud, 2-7 Triple Draw, 2-7 Single Draw, and Badoogie. PokerStars has the world's biggest tournament schedule in terms of guaranteed prizes as well as the amount of tournaments running daily. Having the official Guinness World Record for most participants in an online poker tournament, PokerStars has shown the world that they can host tournaments bigger than any other. Besides the regular tournament schedule, PokerStars hosts yearly events such as the Spring Championship of Online Poker, Micro Millions, World Championship of Online Poker, and Turbo Championship of Online Poker. These events guarantee between $5 million and $40 million in total prizes, but are known to hit even bigger prize pools with massive amounts of players playing. PokerStars sponsored many live poker tournament events also, including the EPT and the PokerStars Caribbean Adventure. PokerStars makes sure that the setup of these tournaments is of the highest quality and guarantees big prize pools. For players who are not able to play these kind of tournaments, PokerStars live streams many of the tournaments directly on their blog website. Here you can see the world's best poker players play, professional commentary, and Team PokerStars guest commentary. PokerStars uses the weighted contributed rake allocation system for all their games. This means that if you pay $0.1 in rake, you'll be awarded VIP points for $0.1 in rake. PokerStars.com has one of the lowest rakes online, with a cash game rake percentage of 1 to 4.5% depending on the games and stakes. For tournaments and sit-and-goes, they charge anywhere between 5% and 20% rake. PokerStars raised their rake significantly in November of 2014, where the rake of tournaments were increased, same for sit-and-goes and heads-up cash games. The rake increase means the players will be paying upwards of 10% more rake overall in a year, which has caused players to complain loudly in the forums. Lastly, to secure fair gaming, PokerStars uses a random number generator to decide the outcome of which cards will be dealt and shown as community cards. PokerStars RNG has been checked by Sigitel, who is one of the largest consulting firms specializing in software security and quality.